Today we will learn the continuation of DC motor drives, that is rectifier control of DC series motor. In that we are going to learn much more, or not only for the DC separately excited motor, but for the DC series motor, chopper control of DC drives, chopper control of DC series motor also. So first we will begin with rectifier control of DC motors. The single phase control rectifier fed DC drives motors are employed. These are mainly employed in traction. The figure here shown is for the single phase half control rectifier fed DC motors. This is a waveform. Since back EMF decreases with the armature current, discontinuous operation is seen in narrow range. The continuous operation will be as shown in the figure. Here, back EMF decreases with the armature current. Discontinuous operation, as told, discontinuous operation is seen in narrow range. In steady state, fluctuating speed are negligible. Back EMF is not constant but fluctuates with armature current IA. For a given speed, back EMF is related to current IA through magnetization curve of motor, which is non-linear owing to saturation. Thus, we can write the equation as E is equal to F of IA into omega M. Then, motor operation is described in two periods. That is, first we will take it as duty interval, and one more is freewheeling interval. You can see here diodes are placed. So in half control, we have two periods. One is a duty interval and the other is a freewheeling interval. So the equations, this equation is being seen in the previous class. So VA is equal to RA IA plus LA into DIA by DT plus back EMF E. So here we will replace VA by VM sin omega T. RA IA remains as it is, plus LA into DIA by DT plus replace back EMF by this equation. Back EMF is given by this equation. So in place of back EMF, substituting the equation 1, we get this equation. This is for the interval from alpha to pi. Next is we need to find the value of A. So the voltage will be 0 in this case. We will substitute 0 is equal to RA IA plus LA DIA by DT plus F of IA into omega M. This is for the period. Two equations we will consider. First equation is from alpha to pi. Next equation is from pi to pi plus alpha. In from pi to pi plus alpha, as you can see here, the voltage will be 0. This is the voltage waveform. This you can see from pi to pi plus alpha, the value of voltage is 0. Hence 0 is equal to RA IA plus LA into DIA by DT plus F of IA into omega M. These are the two equations. Because of the presence of this term F of IA, this becomes a non-linear equation. Hence they have to solve numerically. Let us consider back EMF is directly proportional to speed omega M. Then we can write, after removing the proportionality constant, E is equal to KA into omega M. Then K is F of IA. Let us consider KA as F of IA, that is function of current. We will consider K as a function of current. Since drop across the inductance LA due to DC component of armature current IA is 0, I can write equation VA is equal to EA plus IARA. Then EA will be equal to VA minus IARA. As told, EA is written as KA into omega M. Substituting here, EA is equal to omega M into KA, we get VA minus IARA. Then finding the value of omega M, which is VA minus IARA by KA. Let us consider this equation as A. As we all know, torque is directly proportional to current IA. In order to remove the proportionality, we will introduce the constant KA. T is equal to KA into IA. This is the equation related to discontinuous mode. Now for continuous conduction, VA for fully controlled and half controlled single phase rectifier is given by VA is equal to 1 by pi alpha to pi plus alpha Vm sin omega t d omega t. This equation was obtained in fully controlled rectifier. Then VA is equal to 1 by pi alpha to pi Vm sin omega t d omega t. This is the equation which is obtained in for half controlled rectifier. In the previous section, it's been told, right? The equation is being derived. So let us consider what are the steps to calculate the speed torque characteristics. This is a speed torque characteristics for a given firing angle alpha, taking into account non-linearity of the magnetic circuit. A value has to be chosen for current IA. Corresponding value of KA is obtained from the magnetizing characteristics of the motor. For the known value of alpha, that is the firing angle, calculate VA from the equation depending on the rectifier circuit used. Now, see this equation. Depending upon the value of the firing angle and the rectifier used in your circuit, you can take the equation and find out the value of VA here. If the rectifier used is fully controlled, use this equation and find the value of VA for the known values of alpha. Then if the rectifier used is half controlled, then you can use this equation for the known values of alpha. This is the steps taken to calculate the speed torque curve using the non-linearity of magnetic circuit. This completes the rectifier control of DC series motor. Here also in discontinuous operation we have seen for continuous operation also and the speed torque curve. Next we will move on to chopper control of DC series motor. In chopper control of DC drives. First, we will consider a chopper control of separately excited DC motor. There are four cases where chopper control can be realized. First one is a motoring, second one is regenerative braking, third is motoring and regenerative braking, and fourth one is a dynamic braking. Here, the figure you are seeing is for the motoring action. A transistor chopper control separately excited motor will be as shown in this figure. This is a motor part. Here, transistor, here we use is a transistor. Before thyristors were used, now transistor is used. Transistor TR is operated periodically with the period T. This is the period T. The transistor is operated with the period T and remains on for a duration T on. It will be remain on for the duration T on, and present day choppers operate at a frequency which is high enough to ensure continuous conduction. So during the on period of the transistor, that is T on to zero, this period, the motor terminal voltage is VA. Then RA IA plus LA dIA by dt plus E is equal to V. This will be the case from 0 to T on period, the voltage, the motor terminal voltage will be V. So this equation we can write RA IA plus LA into dIA by dt plus E, which will be equal to V from during this period. So in this interval, armature current increases from IA1 to IA2. As you can see from here to here, it is increasing. It is having a value IA2. That is, in the interval from IA1 to IA2, motor is connected to the source during the interval. This interval, we will call it as a duty interval. At T on, at this period, TR, that is the transistor, is turned off. Motor current freewheels through the diode DF. Motor will freewheel through this diode DF, and motor terminal voltage will be zero. Motor terminal voltage will be zero. This is the voltage waveform. The motor terminal voltage will be zero at T is equal to T on. During this interval, motor operation during this interval is called the freewheeling interval. This interval is called as the freewheeling interval. Then the equation can be written as RA IA plus LA into dIA by dt. Duty interval IA 0, current IA1 will increase. So motor current IA1 to IA2, IA2 to IA1. Current IA will decrease from IA2 to IA1. Then the delta in delta is equal to duty interval, which will be considered as t on by t. Va is equal to 1 by t integration 0 to t on v into dt, which we will consider as delta v. Va is equal to e a I a r a. Ia Ra will be equal to V minus Ea. When calculating the value of Ia, Ia will be equal to V minus Ea Ra. This is the calculation for current Ia. As we all know, Ia is directly proportional to omega m. Then Ia is equal to K omega m. As calculated previously, omega m is equal to V by K minus Ra Ia by K. Substituting the value of omega Ia here, you get the value. Ia is given by V minus Ea by Ra. So Ea can be written as equal to Ea plus Ia Ra. E will be equal to Va minus Ia Ra. Substitute here, omega K is equal to Va minus Ia Ra. Omega K will be equal to Va has been calculated as delta V in the previous section minus Ra Ia. Omega M is equal to delta V by K minus Ra by K into Ia. According to this, T is directly proportional to Ia. T will be equal to K into Ia. Then Ia can be written as T by K. So from this equation, omega M is equal to V by K minus Ra Ia by K. Omega M is equal to V by K minus Ra. Substitute the value of Ia as T by K here. Then omega M is obtained as V by K minus Ra K square into T. So this is a derivation regarding motoring control of separately excited DC motor. In that, we have the speed torque curve here. This is the speed torque curve of motoring control of DC separately excited motor here. So this will remain for this will the curve for motoring as well as the regenerative braking operation. So for regenerative braking operation, chopper control for regenerative braking operation here, this is a transistor TR is operated periodically with a period T and on period T on. Usually an external inductance here, an external inductance is added to increase the value of LA. When TR is on, IA increases from IA1 to IA2. The mechanical energy is converted into electrical by the motor. Now working as a generator, partly increases the stored magnetic energy in the armature circuit inductance and remainder is dissipated in the resistance and transistor. When TR is turned off, armature current flows through diode D here. Armature current will flow through the diode and a diode circuit is not been shown here. Here the diode circuit will be in the diode will be here introduced here. So the when TR is turned off, armature current flows through the diode and shows V and reduces from IA2 to IA1. The stored electromagnetic energy and energy supplied by the machine is fed to the source. The interval 0 to T on, this interval 0 to T on is now called as an energy storage interval. If delta is again defined as the ratio of duty interval to time period T, delta is equal to duty interval by time period, which will be equal to T minus T on by T. Va will be equal to 1 by T, T on to T, V into dT, which will consider as delta V. Then Ia is equal to E minus del V by Ra. This is the equation. Since Ia has reversed, let us consider T is equal to minus K into Ia. Then omega M is given by, omega M is equal to delta V by K minus Ra K square into T. Can see this derivation here. Omega, when you substitute here, instead of V, delta V minus Ra by K square into T. This was regarding motor regenerative braking operation here. This omega M is equal to delta V by K minus Ra K square here. This was regarding the regenerative braking. Next is regenerative braking and motoring action. Chopper circuits of motoring and regenerative braking are combined to provide two quadrant operation gear, which can provide motoring and regenerative braking operation in the forward direction. Transistor TR1 and with diode D1 from a chopper circuit, diode D1 and transistor T1, this will provide the motoring action, therefore provide control for forward motoring operation. Transistor TR2 and with diode D2, with diode D2 will form the regenerative braking operation. Thus, for motoring operation, TR1 is controlled and braking operation TR2 is controlled. Shifting of control from TR1 to TR2, the operation from motoring and vice versa can be obtained. Let us consider an equation IA is equal to del V minus E by RA. Del IA is equal to del V. This, let us consider this equation. In that equation, the equation suggests that motoring operation, if it is, takes place when delta, this delta is greater than E by V, and regenerative braking operation takes place when this delta is less than E by V. Transition from motoring to braking operation occurs when delta is equal to E by V. So this is an important part. This equation, depending upon this equation, we will see whether the operation is motoring or regenerative operation. If delta, this delta value, if it is greater than E by V, then the operation is motoring. And if it is less than E by V, then the operation is regenerative braking. If the system had to shift from motoring to regenerative operation, then delta V should be delta should be equal to E by V. This is regarding regenerative braking and motoring. Here you can see from period 0 to this period D2 is on, and this period transistor TR1 is switched on. Then after this period, diode D1 is on, and from this period to this period, transistor TR2, from this period to this period, diode D2. In this way, the switching from transistor 1 to transistor 2, motoring as well as regenerative braking operation can be obtained. This was regarding regenerative braking and motoring. Now let us move on to dynamic braking. This is the circuit for dynamic braking. In dynamic braking, during the interval from 0 to T on, IA increases from IA1 to IA2. A part of the generated energy is stored in the inductance here, and rest is dissipated in RA and transistor TR. During the interval from T on to T, IA decreases from IA2 to IA1. The energy stored in the inductance is dissipated in braking resistance RB. RA and diode D, in all these three energies dissipated, transistor TR controls the magnitude of energy dissipated in the RB and therefore control its effective value. If IA is assumed to be rippleless DC, then energy consumed EN, let us consider energy consumed EN by RB during a cycle of chopper operation, is EN is equal to IA square RB into T minus T on. Average power consumed by RB is given by P is equal to EN by T, which will be equal to IA square RB into 1 minus delta. Effective value of RB is calculated here. RB P is equal to P by IA square, which will be equal to RB into 1 minus delta, where delta is equal to T on by T. This equation shows that effective value of braking resistor can be changed steplessly from 0 to RB. From 0 to RB, as delta is controlled from 1 to 0. So the maximum value of delta can be from 1 to 0. So we can say that this RB resistance can be controlled steplessly from 0 to RB. 0 to the value of RB. As the speed falls, delta can be increased steplessly to brake the motor at a constant maximum torque. This is regarding dynamic braking. This is the important part here you will have to mention, is that RBE regarding the effective value of RB, that this equation shows the effective value of braking resistor can be changed steplessly from 0 to value RB, and as delta will increase from, delta is controlled from 1 to 0, as the speed falls, delta can be increased steplessly to brake the motor at a constant maximum torque. Now let us move on to the chopper control of DC motor. The circuit diagram will remain same as in case of the motoring control here. The same diagram. This is the same diagram for chopper control of DC series motor. Here also you have motoring, braking as well as motoring regenerative braking as well as the dynamic braking. All the three operation is being seen in chopper control of DC series motor. First, let us see the motoring action. Motoring, due to saturation of magnetic circuit, relationship between back EMF and armature current IA is non-linear. The motor performance can be calculated as in case of similar case of DC series motor. The nature of speed torque is given by, this is the nature of speed torque curve. Here this X, Y axis is omega M. Then this is the torque characteristics. Let us move on to regenerative braking. With chopper control, regenerative braking of series motor can be obtained. Power circuit as in case of regenerative braking will be same as that in case of DC separately excited motor is obtained. During regenerative braking, series motor will function as a self-excited series generator. For self-excitation, current flowing through the field winding should assist residual magnetism. Therefore, when changing from motoring to braking connection, while direction of armature current should reverse, field current should flow in the same direction. This is achieved by reversing the field with respect to armature when changing from motoring to braking operations. Waveform and all remain same as that of the regenerative braking of DC separately excited motor. Let us consider this equation. Omega M is equal to delta V plus IA RA by K. The value of this IA to be negative or positive depends upon the motoring or regenerative operation. As T is equal to minus K into IA, for a chosen value of IA, KA is obtained from the magnetizing characteristics. Then T and omega M are obtained from the equation. From this equation, the nature and speed torque curve is obtained as shown in the figure here. Such characteristics give unstable operation with most of the loads. Consequently, regenerative braking of series motor is difficult when compared to separately excited motor. Then dynamic braking, chopper circuit as in case of separately excited motor is used. Since motor works as a self-excited generator, when changing from motoring to braking, field should be reversed. Dynamic braking is possible in case of DC series, chopper control of DC series motor, but it is very difficult in case of DC separately excited motor. This forms completes the DC motor drives chapter. So these are the things we all have seen in today's session. Okay, thank you.